Now, sa video natin ngayon, sasagutan natin yung mga lumabas sa midterms. Now, this is a combination of terms, concepts, and then also mga problem solving talaga. So, for the first question, we have a truss referred to the figure daw. If P is equal to 34 kilonewtons, Q is equal to 40, and R equals 25, what is the force? Teka lang. Yan. What is the force in member CG daw? Ito. This diagonal member. So, para ma-solve natin to, copy ko na lang dito. Para mas madali natin siyang ma-solve. So, yung Q daw natin equal to 40. Ayan. Sulat na lang natin. And then, P is equal to 34 kilonewtons. And then R naman is 25 kilonewtons. Ayan. Now to solve the force in member CG, we first have to solve the reactions. Diba? Kasi yung ideal cut natin to solve CG is paganto. And tapos apply na lang natin yung method of sections. So, maglalabasa na yung internal forces. So, this would be Fg. Diba? This is Fg. Tapos, this is ano naman? Cg. Ayan. And then, we have Cd. Sige. So, again, for Cg, we can just sum up forces vertical agad. We only need the reaction of the roller support. So, gagawin ko, magmo-moment na lang ako sa A para makukuha ko yung reaction sa E. Now, once makuha ko na yan, I can now apply the method of sections considering the right side. The right side of the cut. Sige, so we have 40 kilonewtons. Clockwise yung rotation niya na makukause about point A. So, we have to multiply this by the perpendicular distance na 3 meters. So, 40 multiplied by 3. And then, we have R. This would be 25. So, plus 25. Clockwise pa rin yung ikot. And then, we have to multiply this by 3, 6, 9. So, 9 yung perpendicular distance. Again ha, we are still considering the entire, anong tawag dito? The entire system. Because we are still solving the external reactions. And then, we have P equal to 34. Now, yung ikot niya about point A is pag counterclockwise. Kasi pag hawakan mo yan and then you will apply this force pag ganyan yung ikot. So, minus 34. And then, the perpendicular distance going to point A would be 5 meters. Ito. So, multiplied by 5. And then, we have the reaction at E. Ito. Sabihin natin EY. So, yung ikot niya about point A is counterclockwise. So, minus EY and then multiply natin by 3 times 4. So, 12 yan yung entire span. Now, equate natin to 0. And so, solving EY, we have 40 times 3. Then, plus 25 times 9, minus 34 times 5, then minus 12x. Set to 0, yung EY natin is 14.583. Ayan. And then, this is kilonewtons. Now, para sa CG, yung kailangan lang natin is the vertical component. So, the vertical component would be, pwede mong gamitin yung angle or pwede rin na ratio and proportion na lang. Pero I think, mas madaling i-type kapag angle. Tapos, isustore na lang natin yung value. So, pwede natin itong kunin. Itong angle na to. Para wala. Ayan, kukunin ko yan. So, to get this angle, I can use arctangent and then opposite over adjacent, diba? So, opposite side is 5, kasi 5 yung height ng triangle na yan. And then divided by the adjacent side, which is 3 meters. Again, now, we are considering this diagonal. Ayan. So, 5 over 3. Then, shift store, lalagay ko sa A, yung theta. So, again, considering the right side of the section, we can sum up forces vertical. Ayan. Lagay na lang natin, right side. So, we would have CG, and then sine theta, and then yung component ng CG vertically is going downward. So, we have to use minus. So, minus CG sine theta, and then yung vertical forces natin would be R, which is 25 going downward. So, minus 25. And then, plus EY. Diba? Again na, we are just considering this portion. Yan, kasi ito yung section cut natin. So, kasali yung 25 sa R, pero hindi nakasali yung Q. Kasi nasa left side na yan ang section. So, plus 14.583. Ayan. So, equate mo lang yan to 0, and then solve CG. So, we would have negative X, then sine theta, minus 25, then plus 14.853. So, just set this one to 0, and then solve CG. So, our CG would be negative 11.83. Ayan. And then, this is in kilonewtons na. Tapos, negative yung lumabas, ibig sabihin, our assumption is wrong. So, lahat ng assumption natin dyan, in tension, therefore, this is in compression pala. Ayan. So, check down natin, ano yung sagot dito. Teka lang, wala yung sagot dito. 12.14 yung nasa choices. Ano daw natin ulit? Input natin ulit. So, negative x, then sine theta, minus 25, then plus 14.583. Yan. Set to 0, we have negative 12.148. So, this is kilonewtons, tapos again, negative yung lumabas. So, mali yung assumption. This is compression pala. Ayan. So, ito pala yung sagot natin. Letter A. So, again na, be careful dito. Since meron din sa choices, 12.148, pero tension. Ayan. So, this would be wrong na. Ayan. Now, proceed tayo sa number 2. Sa number 2, this is just concept lang. So, it is characterized by pulling forces daw at the point or member. And then, arrows are acting away from the point. Ayan. Ito na lang. So, this is tension. Diba? Kasi kapag away from the member or pulling forces, tension. Magiging compression lang kapag pushing forces na. And then, the arrows are acting toward the point or member. And then, for number 3, the algebraic sum of the moments of the components of a force is equal to the moment of the resultant force about the same axis of rotation. So, alam na natin to. This is Varignon's theorem. Ayan. And then, for number 4, it is a force system wherein forces meet at a common point. So, this would be a concurrent force system. And yung mga sinolve natin sa prelim natin. And then for number 5, in the parallelogram law, the diagonal of the parallelogram is the resultant force. Diba? So we would have letter D. Ayan. Kasi again, let's say lang, we have a parallelogram. resulting from a 2-4 system, yan, from here up to here, yan, or the diagonal of the parallelogram, diba, ito yung resultant force. Erase ko lang. Ayan. And then for number 6, refer to the figure shown daw. The following are zero force members. So meron tayong choices dito, and then we have to identify kung saan dyan yung mga zero force members. So una natin gagawin is to check the members na merong, I mean, the joints na merong dalawang members. So joint A has two members, but andyan kasi yung hinge support. So ibig sabihin, AF and AB will not be zero force members. Pero yung EH saka DE, ito silang dalawa, magiging zero force members kasi walang load na inapply dito sa joint E. And then we have two members, EH and DE, automatic na yan sila magiging zero force members. Ayan. And then, ano pa? Magiging zero force member din si CD. Now, bakit zero force member si CD? Kapag natanggal na natin yung EH saka DE, yan, tapos dito tayo sa joint D magsasum up ng forces, diba, the reaction of the roller support is paganto lang, pa-vertical lang. So kapag idodraw mo yung FBD ng joint D, and then na-eliminate na yung EH saka DE, then what happens will be, magiging ganito na yung FBD mo. Yan, ito yung reaction sa roller support, and then this would be CD, and then ito naman yung DH. So you would notice here na kapag magsasum up ka ng forces along X, then CD cannot sustain a force kasi wala namang external load na horizontal. So CD would be a zero force member also. And then looking at joint B, we have three members connected to it. So this one, and this one. So diba, AB and BC are collinear. Parallel silang dalawa. Ibig sabihin, yung member na hindi parallel, yan yung magiging zero force member. So BF is also a zero force member. Yan. Again na, yung 10 kilonewtons kasi, applied at joint F. Hindi kasi siya naka-apply sa B, so this won't sustain a force. So our answer would be BF, CD, EH, and DE. So parang ito yata, BF, EH, DE, CD. Yan. So we have letter A. Now for number 7, it is the perpendicular distance between one force and a certain point. This point is your axis of rotation. So we have the choices, moment arm, moment toe, moment leg, saka moment head. So ginawa kong obvious yan, dito tayo sa moment arm. Yan, bonus na yan. And then for number 8, the resultant force connects the tail of the first force and the head of the last force. Hindi yata na, wait lang. And the head of the last, ayan. So our answer would be letter A. And kasi diba, draw lang natin na. Let's say we have two forces, tapos connect natin sila. Ayan, one is going up and the other is going to the right. Then our resultant force would be this one. From the tail of the first to the head of the last. Yan. Kaya, upward to the right, yan din yung direction ng resultant. Upward and to the right. Ayan. And then for number 9, refer to the figure shown daw. When applying the method of sections for the force in member CF, the most efficient solution can be developed by taking moments about point. Yan yung question. Saan magmo-moment? Now, diba, to solve CF, we can make this cut. Ayan. Tapos, maglalabasan yung internal forces. Ito yung CF. Ito naman yung BC. And then, we have FG. Ayan. notice na the line of action of BC sa ka-FG tatama sa point A. Tingnan nyo. Pag i-extend natin yan, tatama yung FG sa point A, saka yung BC rin. Tatama sa A. Ibig sabihin pala, pag mag-movement ka sa A, then you can eliminate FG and BC automatically. So, agad mo na masosolve yung CF. Ito yung pinakamadali. Therefore, our answer is letter B pala. Ayan. Now, dito naman tayo sa number 10. Refer to stat 003 daw. This figure. Now, the question is, what is the resultant reaction at A if P is equal to 48 kilonewtons? Now, ito yung tinuro ko dati sa example natin sa frames. Pero, diba, I also discussed how to apply two force members. How to identify zero force, I mean, how to identify two force members and then how to use it para mas maging efficient yung solution mo. Now, notice that ABC, ito, member ABC, diba, merong hinge dyan and then merong pin dito. So, pin-connected yung dalawang ends and the notice na yung ABC, walang external loads na applied. Diba, walang force dyan or dito rin. Walang forces dyan. Ibig sabihin, member ABC is actually a two-force member. Therefore, this member pala, draw ko na lang ulit. This is AB and this is BC. Ayan. Therefore pala, itong slope na to, ibayin natin yung kulay. Ayan. From the two pin connections, dyan mag-a-act yung resultant force natin along that slope. And so, this would be a two-force member pala. Parang ganito. Ayan. So, kung ano yung force dito, the same lang yan dito. Therefore pala, to solve the reaction at A, di ba, this is RA. Ayan. This would be RA. So, kapag RA yan, then this would be the same as RA. But, I will just transmit this force patungo sa point C. And then, yan na lang yung i-consider ko. So, draw natin yung member. Again, this is member ABC. And then, this is a two-force member. Two-force member. Ayan. Therefore pala, I can just draw member CDE. And then, agad ko na makukuha yung RA. So, lalagay ko lang yung RA dito. Ayan. This would be point C na to. Diba, this is C. Ayan. Again, we are transmitting RA. Do not consider this one. Para yan sa internal pin. So, ito na yan. And then, this would be point D kung saan in-apply yung load. Ano nga yung P natin? P is 48 kilonewtons. So, 48 kN, tapos the angle of inclination is 40 degrees. Yan. And then we have another hinge support sa point E. Ayan. Now, pwede kong kunin na lang yung triangle na to. Ayan. Now, hindi pala naka-indicate yung height. The height of the frame is 4. Diba? Sinali ko yan sa correction natin. So, kapag 4 yan, parang 4 meters yung height and then this is 2 meters lang. Yan, from B to C. Lagyan ko na lang ah. 2m. So, para maiba naman, gagamitin ko yung ratio ngayon. Kasi kanina, angle yung ginamit natin. So, this is 2, tapos height is 4. So, the hypotenuse would be square root of 4 squared plus 2 squared. Which is 2 square root of 5. Ayan. So, para makuha ko yung RA, then pwede ako mag-moment sa point E. Kasi diba, merong dalawang unknowns dyan. Pangit pag sa A tayo mag-moment. Yan, meron meron kasing EX saka EY. So, para matanggal natin yan, moment tayo sa E. And then, we would have again, this is 2 meters, this is 3 meters. So, yung RA, magkukos ng moment lang is the vertical component. Kasi yung horizontal component niya, yan, tatama sa E. So, hindi siya kasali. Therefore, we have RA, then the vertical component, which is 4, then divided by 2 square root of 5. Nakuha na natin yung vertical component, multiply natin by the moment arm, which is 3 plus 2. So, this would be 5. And then, for the 48 kilonewton load, meron siyang vertical and horizontal components. Lalagay ko na lang yung components, ha? Parang ito yung sa RA, and then ito naman para sa, ito naman para sa, anong tawag dito? Para sa D. Yung load na applied at D. Ito yung components niya. Downward and to the left. So, this would be 48. And then, sine. Sine of 40 degrees. And then, ito naman, 48 cosine 40. Kasi ito yung adjacent side. So, minus 48 sine 40. And then, multiply ko by 3 meters. Yan yung moment arm niya. So, set to 0 muna lang to. And then, solve RA. So, x times 4 divided by 2 square root of 5. And then, multiplied by 5. Then, minus 48 sine 40 multiplied by 3. Set to 0. Yan, masusolve natin yung RA. So, RA is equal to 20.697. This is kilonewtons. Ayan. So again, this qualifies as a two-force member kasi merong hinge sa dalawang ends, pin connected siya, and then walang force na inapply. Now, in the case na merong external force dito, yan, hindi na yan two-force member. Kasi meron ng additional force. Ayan. Sige, so check natin sa choices natin. Andito siya. Ayan. 20.697. Ayan. Now, saan galing yung ibang choices? Try daw natin na isolve natin yung total reaction sa E naman. So, para sa E, diba, yan ay magiging RE. So, we can sum up forces along X to get EX. Ayan. So, summation of forces along X, we would have RA, which is, alam na natin, 20.697. And again na, this is RA. Tapos, kunin natin yung horizontal component niya. So, we have 2, tapos divided by 2 square root of 5. Ayan. And then, next, we have EX going to the left. So, minus EX and then set to 0. Now, you can just move this to the other side and then automatic na. EX will just be equal to this one. So, kunin daw natin yung EX. We have answer times 2 divided by 2 square root of 5. So, 9.256. Ayan. And then kilonewtons going to the left. By the way ha, yung direction ng RA, since positive yung nakuha natin, tama yung assumption natin. And so therefore, this is going upward and to the right. Parang paganyan. And then ito yung EX natin patungo sa left, since positive yung lumabas, and then our assumption is correct. Now to get EY, we can sum up forces along Y. And so we would have RA, which is 20.697, and then multiplied by the vertical component, 4 divided by 2 square root of 5. Ayan. And then minus 48 sine 40, since downward yan, 48 sine 40. And then we have EY going upward. So plus EY, then set natin to 0. For a while. Ayan. So input na lang natin. 20.697 times 4 over 2 square root of 5, then minus 48 sine 40 plus EY. Set to 0, EY natin is 12.342 approximately. So this is kilonewtons, tapos upward siya. Kasi positive yung lumabas, tama yung assumption natin sa EY according to the drawing. So RE would be the resultant force. So parang 9.256 squared plus 12.342 tapos naka-square. Ayan. So kunin daw natin yung resultant. 9.256 squared plus 12.342 squared. So we have 15.427. And then this is kilonewtons. Check down natin. Wala dito. Notice na we have 30.15, 9.25, which is this one. Diba? So baka ma-trick kayo dyan. And then 27.51, 408, wala din dito. So medyo safe ka. Now, kapag gusto mong i-check yung reactions, tapos meron kang pin connections, then you can use this app, yung SWFAA 2D frame. Papakita ko sa inyo. Open lang natin ito. Ayan. So, we have a frame. Diba, pin connected yung frame natin kasi merong internal pin. So, A would be at 0, 0 sa origin na lang. Dito. Yan, 0, 0. And then we have a member, I mean, we have member AB, diba, vertical member. So, it has a height of 4 meters. Tapos, from B to C, we have a distance of 2. So, this would be right here. Ayan. Now, basically, kapag meron kang pin connections, add mo muna yung members patungo sa internal pin. Ayan. So, na-add ko na yung AB saka BC. Ayan. Now, after drawing the members or modeling the members, i-add mo na yung internal pin. And then, once ma-add mo na yung internal pin, isa-sandwich mo na yan sa kabilang member. So, we have CD and DE. Now, mamaya na lang yan. First natin gagawin, lalagyan muna natin ng internal hinge. So to add an internal hinge, just click this one and then add internal pin or hinge. Ayan. Then click mo lang yung node. Yan, nakalagay na dyan yung internal hinge. And then once nakalagay na yung internal hinge, pwede mo na siyang dagdagan ng extra members. So we would have CD, 2 meters yan, yung distance niya. So from here, patungo sa 4 meters. Ah, wait lang. Node yata yung nalagay ko. Wait lang ah. Lagay ko na lang ulit. Ayan. So again, add frame element. And then add internal pin or hinge. And then add a node sa 4 meters. Dito. And then add muna yung frame after na-add yung internal hinge. And then we have 3 meters going to E. So 4 plus 3 magiging 7. Ayan. And then add frame element. And then add natin yung supports. Dito meron tayong hinge. Ayan. Saka sa A rin merong hinge. So click mo lang to. Ayan. May nakalagay na dyan na hinge. And then to add the load, ginawa kong node dyan. Pwede mo naman gawin siyang point load lang. Pero mas maganda kasi pag mag-apply na lang tayo ng nodal point load para mas sure talaga. Click mo lang yung node 3. Yan, yan kasi yung point D. And then we have 48 kilonewtons. And then the angle is 40 degrees. Diba? So input mo lang dito. 40. So click on save. Ito na yung reactions natin. So 9.256 dyan, this is 18.512. So kapag i-check mo yung RA, diba we have 9.256 squared and then plus 18.512 squared. Yan, diba 20.697. Yan yung sagot natin kanina sa RA. Now, parang may mali sa ano natin. Wait lang. May mali sa EX natin. 27.51 dapat. Tama naman yung EY natin. 12.34. Pero bakit mali yung EX? Wait lang ha. 20. Ah, okay. Di ko pala nasali yung 48 cosine 40. Kaya pala. May konting correction tayo ah. So, meron tong 48 cosine 40 towards the left. So, minus. 48 cos 40. Yan yung isa-set natin to 0. Resolve na lang natin ulit. So, 20.697 times 2 divided by 2 square root of 5 and then minus 48 cosine 40 and then minus EX. Ayan. So set to 0. Ito pala. Negative 27.514. Therefore, yung EX natin, instead of going to the left, this is going to the right pala. Yan. Now, sir, bakit right? And then, negative man yan. Again, the negative would indicate na mali yung assumption natin. Sa drawing natin, nag-assume tayo na it is going to the left. Negative yung lumabas na sagot, meaning mali yung assumption. So, dapat pala, to the right pala siya. So, pag titingnan nyo dito, ayan, toward the right, yung 27.514. Ayan, so yung RA pala natin magbabago rin. So this is now 27.514. So kunin mo lang yung square root niya. 27.514 squared plus 12.342 squared. We get 30.155. So this is kilonewtons. Ayan. And then kung gusto niyo yung direction, 'di ba? Upward and to the right. So, paganto pala. Pag ganyan, red. Yan, upward and to the right. Tapos ito rin, upward and to the right din. So, ganyan yung pagkuha ng reactions. Kapag merong internal pin connections. Sige. So, andyan pala talaga sa choices. Tingnan nyo. Merong 27.514, saka meron ding 30.155. Again ha, yung exam nyo, naka-program na yan. So, dito, and if you will press F9, magbabago kasi yung questions. So, for example, bibigyan ko na lang kayo ng bagong problem set. Yan. Press ko yung F9 ah. Ayan. So, notice na kanina, P was 34. Pero ngayon, 37 na. So, ito na yung mga magiging sagot nyo. Dapat. So, pwede nyong i-practice yung bagong problem set natin. Ika-copy-paste ko after solving all of these. Ayan. Saka yung frame, naka-program na din yan. So again, ito yung sagot kapag the question is the total reaction at E. Sige, so sa number 11 naman tayo. Now for number 11, ayan. What is the moment reaction daw at the fixed support? So, our fixed support here is at B. Ayan. So, copy ko na lang to. Ayan. So, diba, kapag meron tayong fixed support, we have three reactions. Merong vertical reaction, merong horizontal reaction din. And then since rotation isn't allowed, then we also have a moment reaction. Now, assume ko siya as clockwise. Yan, MB. Now, BX will just automatically be 0 since walang horizontal loads na applied sa beam natin. So, medyo madali lang yan. And then, hindi natin kailangan yung BY since what's asked is yung MB lang, solely. Therefore, to get the moment at B, sa B din tayo mag-moment to eliminate BY sa solution natin. So we would have 12 kilonewton per not per meter, 12 kilonewton meter, and then this is acting counterclockwise. So minus 12. Ayan. And then dito muna tayo. The 30 kilonewton load will cause a counterclockwise rotation then about point B. So, minus 30, and then our moment arm is 2 meters. So, times 2. And then, for the triangular load, we actually have a resultant. Diba? So, this resultant is 10 multiplied by 5 meters, which is 50. Ayan. And then, this is 1/3 of the base, while this distance is 2/3 of the base. Now again na, this is 2/3 kasi yung mas malaking area andito kasi. So this would be a lesser distance, ito naman this is a greater distance. So this would be 2/3 of the base, which is 5. 2/3 ng 5. Ayan. Now this will cause a counterclockwise rotation about point B. So minus lang tayo ng 50. Ayan, yung resultant niya. Or pwede rin na wait lang, may mali ako dito. Triangle pala yan, sorry. This must be area ng triangle din. So 1/2 times height multiplied by the base. So 25 pala to. 25 kilonewtons. Ibahin ko yung kulay ah. Ayan. So again, you can type 25 here, or pwede rin na wag mo nang isulat yung resultant dyan, and then yung isulat mo lang dito is 1/2 times 10 multiplied by 5. This is already the resultant, and then the moment arm is 2/3 of 5. Yung distance na yan, And then don't forget na mag-a-add pa tayo ng 2. 'Di ba? Kasi yung perpendicular distance ng resultant force na 'yan would be this whole distance. Ayan. So 2/3 of 5 plus 2 meters. And then we have MB, which is acting clockwise. So plus MB. So set to 0. Obvious naman na negative lahat ng signs, pwede mo silang i-move sa kabilang side ng equation. So magiging positive na yan silang lahat. So 12 plus 30 times 2, then plus 1/2 times the base, not hindi base, height pala, height, then base times 2/3 ng 5 plus 2. Ayan. So set to 0. Wait lang. Okay. Hindi na isa-set to 0. Sorry. Yan, equal na lang, automatic. So 205.33. Ito yung MB natin. Now, positive yung lumabas. So this is kilonewton meter and then acting clockwise. Tama yung assumption natin, since positive yung lumabas na sagot. Ayan. So we have here 205.33 clockwise, which is letter C pala. Ayan. Sige, so sa number 12 naman. Refer to the figure shown. What is the reaction at the hinge support? Ayan, so medyo madali lang yung problem na to. Yung medyo tricky lang is naka-overhang kasi siya. So what we are tasked to look for is the reaction at the hinge support. So pwedeng yan na lang yung i-draw mo. Ayan. Ah, diba meron ka ding reaction dyan? So again, this will just be zero kasi walang horizontal force na applied. So we are just interested sa force na to. Sabihin natin this is A, B, C, saka D. So this would be BY. So para makuha natin yung BY, sa C na lang tayo magmo-moment. So summation of moments about point C. Now yung resultant nito would be 13 multiplied by the total distance. Diba? The total distance is 2.5 plus 3.5 plus 2, magiging 8. Ayan. So again, take tayo ng moments about point C. And then we have BY. And then multiply ko yan by 3.5. Yan. Yan yung moment arm niya patungo sa C. And then minus 13 times 8, the resultant load, and then ano yung distance na to? Yan. Again ha, this is acting at the center. Diba? Therefore, kapag 8 yung total distance na to, then this would be 4 meters. Ito naman, 4 din. So, para makuha yung distance na to, we have 4 meters. Then, subtract natin yung 2 meters. Yung overhang distance na to. Yan. Diba? 4 man yan. Then, bawasan natin ng 2. So, the moment arm pala is 4 minus 2. So, lagay ko na lang. This is 2 meters. Ayan. So, set mo lang yan to 0. And then we have BY times 3.5, then minus 13 times 8 times 2. Set to 0, we have 59.429. Ayan. And then this is kilonewtons. So we have ano pala? Letter C. Ayan. And then for number 13, refer to stat 006 daw. What is the reaction at the roller support? So ito yung figure natin. Copy ko dito ah. Ayan. So we are asked to find the reaction at the roller support. Susulat ko lang yung reaction sa hinge. And then yung roller natin, this is BY. Now, para hindi na natin masali yung forces sa A, then it would be ideal na mag-moment na lang tayo sa point A. Ayan. And then, we would have negative BY kasi counterclockwise yung rotation na makukos ng BY about point A. Then, our moment arm is 8 meters. So, multiplied by 8. And then, for the trapezoidal load, meron kang dalawang options, actually. You can split the figure into two. Let's say, meron kang triangular load and a uniform load. Or pwede rin, hindi ko alam kung ano yung mas prefer nyo, pwede rin actually na i-divide mo yung area ng paganto. Yan. So, meron kang dalawang triangles. Diba? So, this is one triangle. This is another triangle. Now, depende na yan sa'yo kung ano yung mas prefer niya talaga. Pero para maiba naman, ito yung gagawin ko. Yung dalawang triangles. Pero again ha, tinuro ko na sa inyo kung paano siya i-divide into uniform and triangular loads. So, ito na lang. Gagawin kong ito na lang yung approach natin. Sige, so for this triangle, yan, we have a height of 2 and a base of 8. So meron siyang resultant dito, which is 1 half times the base multiplied by the height, 2. Ayan. And then diba, going to point A, this is the narrowing portion of the triangle, and then andito yung height ng triangle. So this must be 1/3 of the base, and this is 2/3 of the base. So lagay ko na lang. From here up to this resultant load, this is 2/3 of 8. Ayan. Now, for this triangle naman, ayan, for that triangle, andito yung height ng triangle. Yan yung matabang side ng triangle. Diba? Therefore, the centroid would be located nearer to this one. Kasi ito yung matabang side, ito naman, nag-narrow siya dyan. Papayat siya. Diba? So, andito yung centroid niya, and then we have our resultant. Now, this resultant load would be 1 half times the base na 8. And then, ano yung height niya? 1 half times base na 8. Yan kasi yung mag-act na altitude, di ba? Pag mag-draw ka ng line dyan, papakita ko. Di ba? If you will draw a line here, this is actually 8 meters. Ah, sorry. Yan. 8 meters yan. Parallel dito. Di ba? So, 1 half times base na 8. I mean, not necessarily base. This is the altitude kapag i-rotate mo yung triangle. And then, times the height, which is 10. Ayan. So, equals, ano yan? 0.5 times 8 times 10. So, we have 40. Kunin na lang natin yung numerical values, ha. Yung isa naman, 1 half times 8 times 2, magiging, magka-cancel yung 2, so this will be 8 na lang. Ayan. So, again, this distance from here up to here, sa matabang side yan ng triangle, so 1/3. 1/3 ng base. 1/3 of 8. Ayan. Therefore, we have plus, puro clockwise yung makakos na moments nila. So, 40 times 1/3 ng 8. Tapos, plus 8 naman. And then times, ano yan? 2/3 ng 8. Yan yung moment arm niya. Now, ano yung advantage ng pag-split ng shapes into this form? The advantage is, hindi mo na isusolve yung bagong height. Diba? Kapag isi-split mo siya into triangle and uniform load, then you will have to solve this height. So, magiging 10 minus 2 yan. So, So this is actually just 8. Ayan. But kapag ganito yung pag-split mo, wala ka nang isosolve na height ulit. Pero yun nga lang, pag hindi ka familiar sa location ng resultant ng triangles, baka medyo mahirap siya. Pero again, depende lang yan sa preference mo. Sige, so negative 8x then plus 40 times 1/3 of 8 then plus 8 times 2/3 of 8. Ayan. Then set this one to 0. Masosolve na natin yung reaction. So BY is 18 point non-terminating decimal yan. So gagawin ko na lang 18.67 kilonewtons. So ito yung BY natin. This is acting upward. Saka ito rin ah. Naka-upward din yan. Pag gusto niyo yung directions. So tingnan natin. Letter B pala. Ito yung sagot natin. Now for number 14, a force may be moved anywhere along its line of action without changing its external effect on a rigid body. This is by the principle of transmissibility. Ayan. And then for number 15, moment equals force multiplied by the blank distance. So, diba, this is the perpendicular distance. Yan. Again ha, never yan magiging parallel. Walang ikot na makukos yung parallel distance. Parallel distance sa force mo. Ito naman, number 16. What is the force in member FG daw? This one. So, for FG, balikan natin to ha, yung initial figure natin. The same lang man yan. 40, 34, 25. And then the same figure. So, yung gusto na natin ngayon is FG. Now, meron tayong CG pero let's try solving this one without using what we have solved earlier. So, the most efficient way is to take moments about point C. Diba? Again ha, kailangan natin yung member FG. FG. And then again, kung mahirapan ka pa, kung saan ka magmo-moment, just try to look at common letters. So, we have FG, CG, and CD sa mga internal forces na na-reveal natin. So, notice na merong CD saka CG, common letter yung C. Therefore, pwede kang mag-moment dyan kasi yung lines of action nila tatama sa C. So, you can exclude this one and this one. FG na lang yung matitira. So, moment tayo sa point C. Ayan. Now, yung ginawa ng iba, nag-metal joints pa sila, tapos from the left pa. Now, diba, mahihirapan ka na dyan pag ganyan yung approach mo. Pwede kang mag-metal of joints, pero yung mas madaling way is to consider from the right ka. Let's say, you start from joint E, and then move your way to the left. Yan yung pinaka-ideal kapag method of joints yung gusto mo. Pero ito yung pinaka-maikling solution talaga. So, moment tayo sa point C, still considering the right side of the section. So, we would have R, which is 25, clockwise yung ikot niya about point C. Aga na, dito tayo mag-moment. So, 25 multiplied by 3 meters going to C. And then, again, this is 14.583 kilonewtons. So, 25 times 3. And then, we have P, which is 34. Yung ikot niya about point C is counterclockwise. Diba? So, minus. And then multiplied by 5 meters. Ayan. Then EY will cause a counterclockwise rotation din. So minus 14.583. Tapos yung perpendicular distance is 6. diba? So time 6, and then yung FG magkukos ng counterclockwise rotation according to our assumed direction. So minus FG, then our moment arm is 5 meters. So times 5. Ayan. Now, equate mo lang to 0, makukuha mo na yung FG. So we have 25 times 3 minus 34 times 5. Wait lang. Ayan. Then minus 14.583 times 6 minus FG, and then multiplied by 5 equals 0. So we have negative 36.5. Yan, 4996, that's parang exactly 5 yan. Due to rounding off lang sa ang tawag dito, sa reaction sa ruler natin. So FG equals negative 36.5. Negative yung lumabas, ibig sabihin this is in compression pala. Ayan. So check natin. Ito yung sagot natin. 36.5 compression letter B. So meron ding 36.5 naka-tension. So dyan ka dapat careful. Again, ganito yung type of choices sa board exam. Same values, yung isa compression, yung isa tension. So kailangan alam mo talaga yung ibig sabihin niya. Sige, sa number 17 naman tayo. When applying the method of joints, the number of equations that may be used is 2 lang. Diba? Kasi method of joints, parang concurrent force system lang. Summation of forces horizontal and summation of forces vertical lang yung magagawa mo. You can only add the summation of moments equal to 0 kapag nagme method of sections ka na. Now, sa number 18 naman tayo. So, refer to the figure, still the same figure dito. Pero yung tanong is, what is the force in member BF? Now, sinadya ko yan na medyo madali lang kasi BF is a zero force member. Kasi for joint B, di ba, BC and AB are parallel or collinear, and then yung BF lang yung naiba. Ibig sabihin pala, BF is a zero force member. So, automatic na yan. Letter A. Now, for number 19, it consists of two forces equal in magnitude but opposite in direction, separated by a perpendicular distance. So, again, ginawa kong obvious yan para maging bonus na yan sa inyo. So, our answer for this is couple. Diba? And then for number 20, when given the three sides of a triangle or two sides and their included angle, to solve the unknowns, the cosine law is applicable. Diba? The cosine law is applicable kapag SSS or SAS. Yan. Ito yung pinaka-common talaga. I mean, not pinaka-common. Ito yung dapat yung tandaan. If you can't apply the cosine law, proceed ka na sa sine law. Parang ganyan lang yan. Gusto ko kasing ma-reinforce to para sa plane geometry nyo in the future. Sige, so yan na yung mga sagot natin sa midterms. Maraming nakakuha sa beams. May ibang nakakuha sa truss, but kaunti lang medyo sa frames. Sa item na to. Ito. Online class lang kasi tayo. So, perhaps I will discuss this again sa next meeting natin.